That's a little bit of the beginning of Ciora, a tune by Lee Morgan. And you heard there, right towards the end of that little excerpt, a trill between the B flat and the C. Okay, a trill is a fast alternation between one note and another note. Usually it's a note higher than the note that's notated in the music. So the reason that I played that example is because it's one of the few jazz examples that has a trill. Trills are usually something that you see in classical music. And depending on the style of the music that you're playing classically, there are some different techniques for trills that are important to know. Now, some very popular classical concertos, for example, the Haydn and the trumpet and the Hummel trumpet concerto, there's trills all over these pieces. You'll also see it in the Messiah. You'll see it in all kinds of stuff. And for example, in the second movement of the Hummel trumpet concerto, after the opening note, you're trilling, depending on what kind of trumpet you're playing, you're trilling between an F and an F sharp if you're playing in a B flat on a B flat instrument, and you're going between, I believe it's a C and a C sharp if you're playing it on an E flat trumpet. Now, on the trumpet, some trills are easier than others. For example, a trill from third space C to the D above it is a very difficult trill. It's hard to get it fast, it's hard to get it clean. But if you're doing, so for example, the Hummel example that I just told you from the F to the F sharp, okay, like that. That's a little harder than if you're doing, for example, if you're playing an E-flat trumpet, the notated pitches will be a C to a C-sharp or a D-flat. And that's a little easier trill to do on an E-flat trumpet than it is up there a little higher on the B-flat trumpet. So if you're playing a classical piece and you're actually doing a concerto like that, you might consider using a different trumpet, a C-trumpet. A C trumpet or in this case an E flat trumpet. Those might help those trills become a little easier for you. Now, another thing that you may have noticed, if you know this piece, is when trills are notated, for example that one, and I'm going to be speaking in B flat because that's what most trumpet players play, even though the piece is in E flat. For that you have an F on the top of the staff, in the top line, and then you have another F with the trill notated above it. The trills always go another note above in the key that you're in. So in this case, we're going from an F to a G flat. So that's a half step. And if you also notice, right on the downbeat, I'm not playing another F, but I'm playing the note one pitch above, or one half step above in this case. So, for example, we've got a whole note on the F, and then the trill starts, and I'm starting actually on the note above. It gives a little bit of extra tension, and this is what the style calls for. It's not always does the style call for you to start on the upper note of the trill, but most often it does. So here's the example again. Okay, so If you have a piece with trills on it, make sure you understand, either get some help from your teacher or listen to examples so that you know exactly how you're supposed to do the trill. So when you are doing the trill, it's important to keep the air moving all the time, and oftentimes trills will speed up from the beginning of the trill to the end. And this is another good example of that. Same place. I mostly play jazz, as you probably can tell, and so my classical chops aren't quite what I wish they were. But in All About Trumpet, I actually got a hold of some great classical players to demonstrate this stuff so that you can hear the real deal. Anyway, that's trills in a nutshell. And so to wrap it up, remember that trills go from one note, the notated note, to another pitch higher than the note that's written. And it's the next note higher in the key signature. So it could be a half step, it could be a whole step. And when you do them, make sure you keep your air moving through all the time and be very aware of exactly what kind of style that you're playing in and what that means for your trill, because different styles call for different types of trills. So practice that. Good luck.